Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wa ja'u ala qamisihi bidamin kadhib. Qala bal sawwalat lakum anfusukum amra. Fa sabrun jamil. Wallahu almusta'anu ala ma tasifun. Sadaqallahu alazim. Wa qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam: Ajaban li amril mu'min. Inna amrahu kulluhu khair. وليس ذلك لأحد إلا للمؤمن إن أصابته سراء شكره فكان خيرا له وإن أصابته ضراء صبره فكان خيرا له أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if you remember, in the previous parts of real life lessons from the story of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, I discussed about the dangers of jealousy. I also mentioned that telling a lie is a great sin, and the person who tells a lie does not receive the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is mentioned in the glorious Quran, inna Allah la yusrifu inna Allah la yahdi man huwa musrifun kadhab. I also mentioned a hadith of Sahih Bukhari in which the Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that whoever tries to make himself contented and self-sufficient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him one. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to share one more lesson from this story, and that lesson is about sabr, the patience. So after throwing Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam in the well, his brothers came to their father Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam with the false blood on the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. So Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam replied to them, bal sawwalat lakum anfusukum amra fa sabrun jamil wallahu almusta'anu ala ma tasifun. He said that, nay, but your minds have made up the story, this story which you are telling me. So for me, the patience in this situation is most fitting. This was the reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. And he also said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone whose help can be sought against that which you assert, whatever you have done to my son Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. This was the reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam to his sons. So my dear brothers and sisters, the lesson we learn from the reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam is the lesson of sabr, is the lesson of patience. There is another lesson we learn from the reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, and that is that no matter how evil the crime is, we should always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should always advise the criminal to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. And that's how Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam did, and he said to them, wallahu almusta'an ala ma tasifun. My dear brothers and sisters, unfortunately, a lot of times we jump this step. Someone does a wrong thing to us, so we forget this step. And we immediately defend ourselves. We do not remind him to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we say that, how could you have done that to me? And not only that, sometime we go ahead of that person, whatever he has done to us, we do to him against him, whatever, more than whatever he has done to us. This is our situation. My dear brothers and sisters, what can be more tragic than this, that Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam lost his son? And alhamdulillah, still he was patient. He did not get angry with them. He was not helpless. He was not hopeless. And he trusted in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now if we compare ourselves with this story, with this incident, so sometime a small thing happens to us, we start complaining. If someone, he hurts us a little, we try to hurt him even more than what he did. If we lose our job, we become panicked. And if our business dealings go wrong, so we lose our nerves. And at that time, we can learn the lesson from this story, from the story of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, and from this reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. Whenever any wrong thing happens to us, or we face any kind of difficulty, the patience is the most fitting, my dear brothers and sisters. In those kinds of situations, we should take Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam and other prophets, like for example Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, and even our beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we should take them as role model, and we should behave as our prophets and our beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam behaved whenever they faced the problems and difficulties. The prophets of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, they faced many problems in their lifetime. Allama Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala, he is a great and very prominent scholar. He explained it very beautifully. He said that if this world was not a station of test, it would not be filled with sicknesses and filth. If life was not about hardship, then the prophets and the pious people, the righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would have lived the most comfortable of the lives. But this is not the case, my dear brothers and sisters. If we see back, if we read the history, if we read the glorious Quran, and if we read the ahadith of Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we find different thing. For example, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he suffered from test after test since the time he was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even his coming to this world was a test, was one of the trials he faced. Similarly, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, he cried for 300 years because of the problems, because of the difficulties he faced in his lifetime. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he was thrown in a pit of fire, and he was also tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a command to slaughter his son. Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, as we are talking about him, He cried until he became blind. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam challenged Fir'aun and he was tested by his people. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam had no provision except the morsels his disciples provided him with. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, whose nickname was Sabir because of the patience he had whenever he faced the problems. He was tested with a series of calamities. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, he was very rich. He had huge herds of cattle. He had big farms. He had a large family and many friends. In this situation of prosperity, yet he remained steadfast and the true slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with difficulties. And within a short period of time, he became very poor. He lost his all the things, all the properties, his all family members, except his wife. But he did not lose his hope, my dear brothers and sisters. Rather, he put his entire trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when his sufferings and his loneliness became unbearable, he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, crying, and he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Anni massani yadurru wa anta arhamur rahimin." This is what he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that indeed, distress has seized me, and you are the most merciful of those who show mercy. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him the recovery, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. And it is mentioned in the glorious Quran in ayah number 83 and 84 of Suratul Anbiya, surah number 21. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ذُرْ وَآتَيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا وَذِكْرَى لِلْعَابِدِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we answered his call, the call of Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, and we removed the distress that was on him, and we restored his family to him and the like thereof along with them, as a mercy from ourselves and a reminder for all those people who worship us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is the reminder for all of us. These things, this dua of Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, the reply of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam to his sons, and then the acceptance of the dua from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the reminder for all of us. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, he showed the great patience throughout the worst of disasters. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did to him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only rewarded him in the hereafter, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala redoubled his former prosperity in this world. And then after that, he lived a long life. When he passed away, he was 93 years old, and he was one of the richest people of that time. This was the result of patience and putting the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded him back. And now let's come to our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was tested the most. First of all, he was born as an orphan. Then after that, he lost his near and dear ones while he was very young. He was tested with poverty, with hunger, with boycott, with the death of all his children in his lifetime except the Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. And one of his uncles, Hamza radiallahu ta'ala an, he was one of the most beloved relatives to him. He was slain and mutilated in his prisons. These were the tests our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam faced, my dear brothers and sisters. Not only that, he was tested with insult, with migration from his hometown. He was also tested with a huge booty over his head, the threat of being killed, an unsuccessful plot of attack with a huge stone over his head, and the poison in his food, and so on and so forth. These are some of the things which I mentioned in front of you. Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was tested with. So these all the things, if we recall these things, whatever we face in our lifetime, whatever we face, these all things are nothing comparing to the things happened to the prophets of Allah alayhim salatu wasalam, and especially to the prophet, to our beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So this teaches us that we should always be patient in all situations. Everything, whatever happens to us, it happens for our own good. There is a hadith recorded by Imam Muslim. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that عجبًا لأمر المؤمن إن أمره كله خير وليس ذلك لأحد إلا للمؤمن إن أصابته سراء شكر فكان خيرا له وإن أصابته ضراء صبر فكان خيرا له. It's a beautiful hadith, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that strange is the affair of the believer. Indeed, all his affairs are good for him. And this is not for anyone except for the believer. If something pleasing befalls him, he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it becomes better for him. And if something harmful befalls him, he is patient and it becomes better for him. If he thinks that whatever is happening to him, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him in the hereafter and in this world also, so whatever difficulties a believer faces, he does not lose his hope. He does not become helpless. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam and the teachings of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam attaches great importance to patience. The glorious Quran repeatedly stresses on the need of patience. It talks about patience in about 200 ayat directly and in many other ayat indirectly. For example, in ayah number 17 of Surah Luqman, Surah number 31, we are enjoined to remain patient with these words. Luqman alayhi salatu wasalam is advising his son and he said, وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. That bear with patience over whatever befalls you. It's just general thing is being mentioned in the glorious Quran. It does not matter that whatever happens, whatever befalls you, whatever happens to you, just be patient. Indeed, this is the steadiest of courses. And similarly, there are several ahadiths, many and many ahadiths of Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have laid great importance for this quality, for patience. For example, there is a hadith in Sahih Tirmidhi. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala is the narrator of the hadith. He said that the Prophet of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, عِظَمُ الْجَزَاءِ مَا عِظَمُ الْبَلَاءِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ قَوْمًا إِبْتَلَاهُمْ فَمَنْ رَضِيَ فَلَهُ الرِّضَى وَمَنْ سَخِطَ فَلَهُ السُّخْطِ. That the greatest reward comes with the greatest trial. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a people, He tests them. Whoever accepts that wins His pleasure, wins the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But whoever is discontent with that, with the trial and with difficulties he is facing, he earns the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does become angry with him. My dear brothers and sisters, patience is an attribute without which the very thought of Islam and the teachings of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are unimaginable. I will conclude with a hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which tells us how to behave when we face any difficulty in our life. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the example of a believer is that of a fresh, tender plant. From whatever direction the wind comes, it bends it. But when it becomes quiet, it becomes straight again. Similarly, a believer is afflicted with calamities, but he remains patient till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes his difficulties. And an impious, a wicked person who is not righteous, his example is like a pine tree which keeps hard and straight till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cuts it down whenever he wishes. So beautiful example Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave in this hadith about the situation, about the behavior of a believer, how he should behave whenever he is suffering from any kinds of problems, he is facing hard time in his lifetime. So we should have just these words of Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our mind, and we should always trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the ajr, the more ajr in the akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to have patience in all situations. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His blessings upon us. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have several requests for dua. Sister of Brother Alauddin, she is in New York. She is very sick. So make dua for her. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her shifa. There is another request for dua for a sister, Mrs. Ahmed. She passed away in Nashville. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her. There is another brother, Hafiz and Qari Akram Pasha, who passed away in India. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Make dua for him also. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all those who passed away and give them the best place in Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.